The very meaninglessness of life forces man to create his own meaning. The above quote comes from one of the greatest directors of all time. The most interesting thing that I find about Stanley Kubrick is his ability to channel his philosophy in the art that he created, as well as to use art as a means of swimming deep down in the mysterious ocean of life. Raised in Bronx, New York, from an early age in life, Stanley Kubrick was interested in art and especially the art of photography. And the photographs he took gave a real insight into 19-year-old Stanley's view of life. His photographs present, with a certain rawness in them, moments of life he considered as beautiful and worth capturing. The love for photography eventually transformed into cinema, and this is where Stanley's philosophy flows into his work. Stanley's view of life is one where there is a certain kind of harmony between the absurd and the meaningful. Kubrick states that we as children begin life with an untarnished sense of wonder, a capacity to experience total joy at something as simple as the greenness of a leaf. But as we grow older, the awareness of death and decay begins to impinge on our consciousness and subtly erode our joy of life, our idealism, and our assumption of immortality. We begin to lose faith in the ultimate goodness of man. But this is not a conclusion, but rather an opportunity to question what it is that matters in life. As Stanley writes, "If man merely sat back and thought about his impending termination and his terrifying insignificance and aloneness in the cosmos, he would surely go mad or succumb to a numbing sense of futility. Why, he might ask himself, should he bother to write a great symphony or strive to make a living or even to love another, when he is no more than a momentary microbe on a dust mote whirling through the unimaginable immensity of space?" Stanley's question is one where, as Camus describes, man stands face to face with the irrational. He feels within him his longing for happiness and reason. The absurd is born of this confrontation between the human need and the unreasonable silence of the world. And this notion, this confrontation, is something we witness flowing in Stanley's work. The idea of the absurd shines especially in 2001: A Space Odyssey. The very nature of the monolith in the movie is an absurd one. The monolith is not something unreal, it is an unchanging eternal reality. From apes to mankind to the star child, the monolith represents an unchanging substratum for all of these. It represents something that precedes not only man, but his ability to draw meaningful conclusions as well. Something incomprehensible, something that transcends our notions of space, time, and existence. A lot can be said about it, but very little could be explained. As Kubrick writes, "The whole idea of God is absurd. If anything, 2001 shows that what some people call God is simply an acceptable term for their ignorance. What they don't understand, they call God. Those of us who recognize that there is no purpose they can comprehend, and that amidst a countless myriad of stars their existence goes unknown and unchronicled, can fall prey all too easily to the ultimate anomie. But if one is reasonably strong and lucky, one can emerge from this twilight of the soul into a rebirth of life's elan. Both because of and in spite of his awareness of the meaninglessness of life, he can forge a fresh sense of purpose and affirmation. He may not recapture the same pure sense of wonder he was born with, but he can shape something far more enduring and sustaining." Kubrick saw life as a set of puzzles demanding not only to be solved but experienced as well. What statements fail to explain, these puzzles and mysteries of life offer a chance to explore for oneself and discover. As he said, "There's something in the human personality which resents things that are clear, and conversely, something which is attracted to puzzles, enigmas, and allegories." 2001: A Space Odyssey is not an answer or a statement, but rather an invitation to be immersed in the experience of the mysterious. It is the very mysterious nature, according to Kubrick, that drives us, the way we fall in love without exactly knowing what love is. And these puzzles, the silence of the world that we are faced with, is something to be challenged and revolted against, something to be explored, not in the conventional ways of being, but through creative pursuits like philosophy and art. Or the way Camus writes it, "Art at least teaches us that man cannot be explained by history alone. There are certain areas of feeling and reality, or unreality, or innermost yearning, whatever you want to call it, which are notably inaccessible to words. Music can get into these areas. Painting can get into them. Non-verbal forms of expression can. But words are a terrible straitjacket. It's interesting how many prisoners of that straitjacket resent its being loosened or taken off. There's a side to the human personality that somehow senses that wherever the cosmic truth may lie, it doesn't lie in A, B, C, D. It lies somewhere in the mysterious, unknowable aspects of thought and life and experience. The most terrifying fact about the universe, stated Stanley, is not that it is hostile, but that it is indifferent. But if we can come to terms with this indifference and accept the challenges of life within the boundaries of death, however mutable man may be able to make them, our existence as a species can have genuine meaning and fulfillment. However vast the darkness, we must supply our own light. I hope this was meaningful for you or at least provided you with a new perspective. If you like this video and want to support more of these, check the link in the description. Any donation is helpful and genuinely appreciated. If you want me to cover more on these themes, let me know in the comments below. I make videos on metaphysics and philosophy, both Eastern and Western, as well as movies, artworks, books, and other stuff like this. Thank you for watching.